Proverbs chapter 30, verses 7 through 9 says, "Two things I ask of you, O Lord. Do not refuse me before I die. Keep falsehood and lies far from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches, but give me only my daily bread. Otherwise, I may have too much and disown you and say, 'Who is the Lord?' Or I may become poor and steal and so dishonor the name of my God." We live in a world where wealth is seen as one of the greatest achievements you can have in life. The one with the most expensive stuff is seen as the person who was successful. That's probably part of what makes Batman such a popular hero. He's wealthy beyond our wildest imaginations. His story starts off with great tragedy, losing his parents at such a young age, leaving a void that no earthly treasure can fill. Yet he's a billionaire, able to afford every weapon and tool you could ever need, even building entire space stations for other heroes to use, all in the hopes of preventing crime from destroying other families. His wealth seems to allow him to do anything. But there's danger in having that much wealth that we often miss when we're looking from the outside. Even though we usually think that wealth gives us freedom to do whatever we want, it can often become a prison as well, taking control of our life. We become dependent on it, and we need to protect it. What if someone robs me? What if I lose it? How can I be sure my possessions are safe? This proverb is a warning to us that we need to avoid the extremes. Obviously, we don't want to be in poverty, because then we might become so hungry that we're tempted to steal to survive. But we also don't want excessive riches, either. If we have too much treasure on this earth, we stop thinking so much about the eternal treasures. Our hearts become so engrossed with our treasures here that we start missing out on what God is offering us. Our wealth actually ends up being a prison for us. Sometimes we have to get rid of some of our riches in order to really be free. That is an interesting twist in the Dark Knight Rises movie. The villain Bane comes to Gotham, and he knows Batman's secret. Most of all, he knows how to take Batman down, go after his wealth. A raid on the stock exchange allows him to fake Bruce Wayne's identification, and in a single moment, he is able to cost Batman his entire fortune. How can Batman win without his unlimited wealth? But of course, Batman is able to win, eventually. But more than win, the Dark Knight Rises movie gives Batman something we rarely see in any Batman story: a happy ending. After making it look like he was killed in the nuclear explosion he saved the city from, Bruce Wayne is finally able to retire and find peace. No more chains from his wealth or company, no more burden of constantly protecting the city. We see him finally enjoy his reward for living a life of sacrifice. He gains the freedom Alfred always hoped he would. It may sound strange to us, but the same is kind of true of our eternal rewards that we're striving for. When our eyes are fixed on heaven, we realize we can't take our wealth with us. We'll be leaving it all behind when we die. Of course, we should use our possessions wisely on this earth and not squander them doing silly things, but we shouldn't be so attached to them that they make us a prisoner. Just like Bruce Wayne in Dark Knight Rises, we use what we have to do good, being obedient to God as best we can, and in the end, we leave it all behind as we journey into what God has next for us. So don't leave yourself in poverty, but also don't seek out great wealth. Everything we have here on earth can be stolen or destroyed. So focus on the eternal things that last: faith, hope, and love, because no one can ever steal that from you.
I'm sorry they took all your money.
No, you're not.